Dude, get out of my shop. There's potentially 1,000 people watching this. How is it going, fellow photophiles? My name is Ilya and welcome to the weekly Wednesday vlog. As you know, I'm a huge fan of YouTube as a platform, even though rumor has it is on the downhill. But tell me what you think in the comments. Is YouTube dying? Anyway, today I'm gonna touch on one of the most recently added features, premieres. According to YouTube, they're rolling out this feature in batches, so you may or may not have it yet, but either way, I hope this information is gonna be useful. Now, there are plenty of video and other format tutorials out there teaching you how to use this feature, but I wanted to target a more complicated question, and that is why, and more importantly, how you can benefit from using this feature. First off, a small comprehensive explanation of what YouTube premieres are in case you're not acquainted with them yet. Essentially, it's a pre-notified scheduled live stream of your video. When you upload a video and select the premiere option, YouTube automatically creates a watch page and then notifies your subscribers. So now they see a static thumbnail and a countdown for when that video will be live. And just like on live videos, they can comment as they watch together with other viewers and yourself. And after that, the video stays on your channel like any other regular video. I think this is an awesome step from YouTube's side as it changes video watching from passive to interactive, combining the best of regular videos and live streams into a win-win hybrid.
Never mind that it got 41% dislikes on the official YouTube Spotlight channel.
And now for the reasons why you should utilize this feature for your channel. First off, you can use the algorithm to your advantage. Anything related to the YouTube algorithm is kind of a guessing game because nobody really knows what's going on in the code of it. But it's pretty obvious that across social media platforms like Instagram, Facebook, and YouTube, of course, the developers push the new features that they introduced to the top to encourage people to use them more. When Instagram live streams came out, you pretty much turn on a live and you get a dozen viewers right away from randomly around Instagram because Instagram was promoting that live video so much. Same thing goes from IGTV. You launch a video and it pretty much pops a notification on everyone's feed. So I think it's safe to assume that YouTube is going to promote videos that are using premieres. Number two is building hype with your audience. While most YouTubers have an upload schedule that their audience are aware of, so there is that kind of level anticipation, this brings it up to a whole other level. Because now people know in days, hours, minutes, and seconds when that video is going to be. And the live chat can be open for them to interact with each other and increase that anticipation even more. Number three is pre-generating engagement. Since that video's watch page is public before you actually launch the video, you're generating engagement with your video before you ever publish anything. So you get views, likes, comments, and everything on your video before it's even launched. Number four is increasing the initial boost of your video. You may know that the performance of a video in its first half hour, 1 hour, 2 hour is very important for how that video performs overall. So if a part of your audience, knowing exactly when the video will be published, is watching that video at the moment it's published, you get a huge viewing and engagement spike in the beginning, which is bound to propel the video forwards in the future. Number five is live interaction while maintaining pre-recorded quality. Lives are very popular because people can communicate in real time with the creator, but then usually the drawback is low quality of the video. Because the high camera bit rates of a quality video recorded by a camera takes a lot of internet. Most uploaders don't have that kind of internet, not to mention that most DSLRs out there aren't capable of live streaming. But this way you can upload your high quality video like usual and still interact with your audience real time as they're watching it. Number six is more revenue. Of course, this only applies to monetized channels, but this brings the monetization capabilities of live streaming into regular videos as well. And there are two main methods. You have the monthly membership subscriptions, which is only available for channels over 50,000 subscribers, and Super Chat, which is people specifically buying messages that are highlighted and whatever. And number seven is increased engagement. All those pre-likes and likes and watches, pre-comments and comments during the live stream, and people are bound to comment during a live stream or a live session a lot more, they stay after the video is published and stays on your channel. So potentially that video that has been premiered is gonna get a lot more engagement than your regular published video. If you think these reasons are worthwhile to use Premiere, drop this video a like. That's all great, but we should probably not ignore some of the drawbacks of this feature. First of all, you're gonna have to change your schedule a little bit because you're gonna have to be uploading earlier. For example, I publish on Wednesday, but if I want to premiere a few days ahead of time, I have to have my video ready by Saturday or Sunday and have it up so it can be premiered before Wednesday, so say on Monday. Which is honestly not a big deal, because all you have to do is either create two videos in fast progression or skip a week and then publish your next video earlier than usual. But a bigger problem is competing for prime watch time with big channels. If you and say five other more popular channels scheduled a premiere on the same day in roughly the same time like the prime watch time in your country, chances are part of your audience is watching the videos of that channel instead of yours, which is taking away from your engagement. But I mean, they can always come back to your channel and watch the video later, so maybe it's not a big deal after all. Meanwhile, we have yet to look forward to YouTube Stories, or whatever it's gonna be called, which is YouTube's take on Instagram Stories and how that's gonna function on this platform and in the app and everything, but I guess we're gonna see. I hope you enjoyed this video and got some useful information, and as always, I'm gonna see you guys next week. And I'm gonna need a while getting used to this super wide shot. It's weird.